Good morning, children. I hope you all are fine. Welcome to our class. Last class, I already given worksheet. Did you complete, children? Yes. And homework also. Now, today, I will tell you answers. Once check your answers. Okay? Chhattisgarh, Odisha, North to Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, South to Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, West to Andhra Pradesh, Bay of Bengal, East to Andhra Pradesh. That is the first matching. And now second matching, district, states, capital, we can see in political map, and mountains, plateaus, plains or physical map, distribution of people, thematic map, and boundaries of kingdom is in historical map. Okay. Now, again, I am giving you another worksheet, that is rain and water. Okay, now I will read all the blanks. Just read yourself also so that you can get answers. First one, dash of the earth's surface is covered with water. Change of water into vapor is known as dash. There are dash arms of the monsoon winds. Dash is an instrument by which the rainfall is measured. In our state, we have dash, main, deltas. So, first one, dash of the earth surface is covered with water. How much percentage of water is there? That is 71%. How much? That is percentage of 71. Okay, then second one, the change of water into vapor is known as dash. So, what is the process? If the water is changing into vapor, is known as evaporation. What is that? Evaporation. And third one is, there are dash arms of the monsoon winds. So how many arms of monsoon winds? There are two arms of monsoon winds. That is here, one from blow from Arabian Sea and another one Bay of Bengal. Isn't it? There are two arms of monsoon winds. And fourth one, dash is an instrument by which the rainfall is measured. So we can measure rainfall. Then how? One instrument is there. What is that? That is rain gauge. Okay, what is that? That is rain gauge. And last one, in our state we have dash, main, deltas. So, how many deltas are there? There are two deltas. Those are Godavari Delta and the Krishna Delta. About the Krishna Delta, you already learned in 6th class, isn't it? What is the shape of the delta? Triangle. Yes. Now, I will read it again. See, 71% of the earth's surface is covered with water. Change of water into vapor is known as evaporation. There are two arms of the monsoon winds. Rain gauge is an instrument by which the rainfall is measured. And fifth one, in our state, we have two main deltas. Now again, sixth one. The river Krishna and Godavari start from the dash. Ganga and its tributaries originate in dash. Small rivers and streams which join a large river are called dash. Godavari, Trayambak, Krishna, dash. The southwest monsoon, however, brings much rain to the dash. Now, sixth one. You also read yourself, children. Okay. The river Krishna and Godavari start from. Where it start from? River Krishna and Godavari. These are the famous rivers in our AP. Isn't it? So, where it start? It start from Western Ghats. So, see here. This is the. We can locate like this. Western Ghats. And this side, Eastern Ghats. So, both rivers are start from Western Ghats. And seventh one, Ganga and its tributaries originate in dash. So Ganga. Ganga originate and their tributaries also. Where it originate? What is the birthplace of Ganga? It is in Himalayan mountains and Gomukh. Okay, Himalayan mountains. Ganga and its tributaries originate in Himalayan. Himalayan mountains. Okay, and eighth one, small rivers and streams which join a large river are called. So small rivers and streams, they join in one big river, that is called tributaries. What do we call? Tributaries. Okay, next, ninth one, Godavari Triangle, Krishna Dash. So Godavari originate in Nasik at Triumbark, and as well as Krishna also, where Krishna's birthplace, that is Mahabaleshwar. Mahabaleshwar. Now tenth one, the southwest monsoon however brings much rain to the Dash states. Which states? That is Telangana. Okay, now I'll read out again, children. The river Krishna and Godavari start from the western Ghats. Ganga and its tributaries originate in Himalayan mountains. Small rivers are streams which join a large river are called tributaries. Godavari, Triambak, Krishna, Mahabaleshwar. Tenth one, the southwest monsoon, however, brings much rain to the Telangana. And now choose the correct answers. First one, Dash is the main tributary of the river Krishna. Options are Manjira, Musi, Dandi, Tungabhadra. In coastal Andhra Pradesh, at least Dash villages were washed away by the cyclonic storms in 1977. Options are 50, 75, 125. Third one, water vapor changes into water. The phenomenon is known as Dash. A. Evaporation. B. Condensation. C. Precipitation. D. Humidity. So here, now see, first one, Dash is the main tributary of river Ganga. So what is the main tributary here? Already options are there. Once think and say your answer. What is that? That is Tungabhadra. Okay? D. And second one, in coastal Andhra Pradesh, at least Dash villages were washed away by the cyclonic storm in 1977. See, 1977, one big storm is there. What is that? Cyclonic storm. At which place it came? In coastal Andhra Pradesh. How many villages are washed away? There are how many villages? Options are there. How many villages? There are 100 villages. Isn't it? And third one, water vapor is changes into water. The phenomenon is known as, though the water vapor is changes into again water. What is that phenomenon? We known as evaporation, condensation, or precipitation, or humidity. Which is the correct one? The correct one is condensation. That is B. Again, I will read out, children. Once look at the board. Dash is the main tributary of the river Krishna, that is Tungabhadra. The coastal Andhra Pradesh, at least Dash villages were washed away by the cyclonic storms in 1977. 100 villages. Water vapor changes into water. The phenomenon is known as condensation. Again, fourth one, different forms of condensation of water vapor is known as Dash. Options are evaporation, water cycle, precipitation, humidity. Fifth one, tiny droplets together dash. Options A, increase heat, B, form as a clouds, C, drop as a rain, D, all the above. Sixth one, the worst cyclone hit the east coast in dash. A, November 1977, November 1977, November 1978 and December 1977. Now see, different forms of condensation of water vapor is known as dash. What is the process? What do we call that process? Different forms of condensation of water vapor. That is called precipitation. What is that? That is precipitation. And next one, tiny droplets together dash. How it forms? Is it increase heat, form as a clouds, drop as a rain, all the above? Which is the correct one? The correct one is form as a clouds. So here, the worst cyclone hit the east coast in dash year. So worst cyclone happened in east coast, and which year that one happened? That is November 1977. And again I will read out different forms of condensation of water vapor is known as precipitation. Tiny droplets together form as clouds. The worst cyclone hit the east coast in November 1977. Now seventh one, the amount of invisible water vapor present in the atmosphere is known as dash. Options are evaporation, water cycle, precipitation, humidity. And my eighth one, which one of the following rivers doesn't start in Western Ghats? Options are Godavari, Krishna, Ganga and Penna. Okay, now see, which is the correct one? The amount of the invisible water vapor present in our atmosphere is known as, is it evaporation, water cycle, precipitation or humidity? The answer is humidity. So that is the invisible water vapor present in atmosphere, that is humidity. And which one of the following rivers doesn't start in Western Ghats? Here four rivers given here, Godavari, Krishna, Ganga, Penna. So which river doesn't start in Western Ghats? What is that? That is Ganga. Again I will read out, the amount of invisible water vapor present in the atmosphere is known as humidity. Which one of the following rivers doesn't start in Western Ghats, that is Ganga river. Now ninth one, which one of the following diseases is not spread due to floods? Options are cholera, swine flu, dysentery, jaundice. And tenth one, which one of the following is a man-made disaster? Cyclone, earthquake, tsunami, train accident. So which one of the following diseases is not spread due to floods? What is that? Which disease is not spread due to floods? That is swine flu. Remaining three, they are spread with floods only. Okay. Tenth one, which one of the following is man-made disaster? What is that? Man-made disaster. Is it cyclone, earthquake, tsunami or train accident? The answer is train accident. Man-made disaster. Remaining three are only disasters. Okay. Now we'll read it again. Which one of the following diseases is not spread due to plants? Swine flu. Which one of the following is man-made disaster? Train accident. Students, I already completed second lesson worksheet. Okay, now worksheet for third lesson, that is tanks and groundwater. Now I will read out. You also read yourself. First one, our ancestors have tried to use rainwater by building dams. Options are tanks, borewells, dams. Second one, rocks which have cracks or pores in them and can contain water are called dash. Pervious rocks, impervious rocks, granites and limestones. So first one, what is the correct answer? What did they do? Ancestors means forefathers. What did they do in the those days to use rainwater? They build tanks. What did they build? They build tanks. And second one, rocks which have cracks or pores in them and can contain the water are called. So some rocks will be there, those have cracks and pores and also they contain water. What do we call? Is it impervious pervious rocks or impervious rocks, granites or limestones? The answer is pervious rocks, that is A. But in impervious rocks, the water cannot go beneath them. Okay? Do you understand the difference between pervious rocks and impervious rocks? Okay, now I will read it again. Our ancestors have tried to use rainwater by building tanks. Rocks which have cracks or pores in them and can contain water are called pervious rocks. Now third one, the layer of water which accumulates under the ground among rocks is called dash. Topsoil, shale rock, limestone, aquifer. Next one, the level of groundwater is also called dash. Water table, water cycle, water tanks, waterfalls. Now third one, what is the answer here? The layer of water which accumulates under the ground among the rocks is called aquifer. And aquifer determines the availability of groundwater also, isn't it? The level of groundwater is also called dash. What is the level of groundwater? Is it water table, water cycle, water tanks or waterfalls? That is water table. Now we will read it again. The layer of water which accumulates under the ground among rocks is called aquifer. The level of groundwater is also called water table. Now seventh one. Groundwater is usually mixed with many water, tanks, minerals, vegetation. Sandstones are found in Das district, Guntur, Krishna, Anantapur, Prakasham. Pakalacheruvu is in which district? Chittur, Anantapur, Karnool, Krishna. Now which is the correct answer here? Groundwater is usually mixed with many minerals, isn't it? And sixth one, sandstones are found in Das district. Which district we can found? Is it Guntur, Krishna, Anantapur or Prakasham? The answer is Prakasham district. And Pakalacheruvu is in which district? Pakalacheruvu. In which district it is there? Is it Chittur, Anantapur, Karnool or Krishna? The answer is Chittur. Okay, now I will read it again. Groundwater is usually mixed with many minerals. Sandstones are found in Prakasham district. Pakala Cheruvu is in which district? Chittoor district. Now, 8th one. A person who regulated the use of water from the tank. Options are Neeru Katte Manishi, Neerati, Unemployed, both A and B. 9th one, the arid region of our country is dash Punjab, Rajasthan, Meghalaya, Kerala. Here 8th one, what is the answer? A person who regulated the use of water. They will appoint one person to regulate the use of water. What is the answer? Neeru Katte Manishi, Neerati, Unemployed, or both A and B? The answer is both A and B. Why? Because we can call it Neeru Katte Manishi or Neerati. We can call him. And 9th one, the arid region of our country is dash. Arid means a little rain or no rain. Is it? So, what is that arid region of our country? Which region that is? Is it Punjab, Rajasthan, Meghalaya or Kerala? The answer is Rajasthan. Now I will read it again. A person who regulated the use of water from the tank, Neeru Katte Manishi, Neerati. The arid region of our country is Rajasthan. Now 10th one, the trails to increase water table are called options watershed development programs, Dharavahikalu, water storage projects, water capacity projects. So what they are doing to trails to increase water table? To increase water table means level of groundwater. What is the water table? It is the level of groundwater. To increase that one, what are the trails they are doing? Answer is watershed development programs. Now I will read it again, children. The trails to increase water table are called watershed development programs. So here I completed 10 blanks. Okay, children. Now, what you have to do, whatever I said today, you have to read and write it in your home, in your book. So that is the homework for you. Is it? Understand? Okay. Read well and write well. And concentrate on your studies. Don't waste your time. Understand, children? Use your time properly and fruitfully. Thank you. Have a nice day. I will see you in the next class.